I'm your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here failing at getting my goddamn timer started because something's gone wrong on my phone. So I'm having to fucking sit here trying to get my timer going.
It's Garrett! Get the castellan! Tell him his nephew survived!
You know what? Fuck it. What time is it? Let's just check that. Okay. Sorry! Yes, Game of Thrones! Adventure game! Telltale! Limping! Garrett. Jesus, they got the castellan quick. That guy must have been looking out for it.
They were already dead.
Bring the maester. Meet us in the Great Hall. Quickly.
Sorry, mate. Haven't I already heard your voice actor before? Fairly certain that you played someone else roughly 10 minutes ago.
Two White Hill soldiers and a Bolton. They killed my family.
Of course that's me. Of course there's a Bolton there. There's always a Bolton.
My sister, she...
Boltons are just pricks. Wherever there's a prick in the north, chances are it's a goddamn Bolton.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
I imagine the Starks would have shown up, kicked the fuck out of the Boltons. Riding on wolves! Turning into wolves, riding on wolves!
Deep, but I should be able to save your leg.
Oh, that's good.
Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the White Hills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you.
I'd do it again if I had the chance.
If we don't respond with strength, they won't stop until they have everything. These maggots ought to help prevent infection. Hold the wound open for me, would you?
I know that is like an actual medical thing, and I know that even today, some places... That some places do use maggots to clear up like necrotized flesh, but oh god,
Lord of the house and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man, and poor Roderick, a serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Our house will never fall.
By the gods, let's hope you're right.
Is it just me, or does everyone have the same haircut and beard in this house?
Although he is young, and altogether unprepared to lead.
Hold up, there's one of the characters in this called Lord Ethan.
this might hurt a bit.
Oh, great. Do we get another... I'm getting the feeling that Telltale enjoy, like, putting their characters through intense pain way too much.
I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son, Roderick.
But Roderick was dead at the time.
Not that Roderick couldn't handle himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft.
That's not how it happened. Roderick had already fallen.
Well, I'd imagine Lord Forrester would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low.
Respectable man, apparently.
Lady Forrester will be here any moment now.
To give you shit
I'd
for
like
letting her husband die.
First. To see if you can put any weight on that leg.
Yeah, don't even give him a cane or anything. Oh, no, apparently putting a bandage on it and it's fine.
Go on. Don't stop now.
Jesus
it's
Christ.
Better to let the blood circulate.
The maggots in there must tickle something fierce. That would be awful. Ooh, I'm going to look at the Lord's chair. Let's have a good old stare at this chair, shall we? Blood in his boot. Didn't even clean his boot. Come on. Must have a cloth. Wipe the son of a bitch. Really? No witty commentary. Okay, let's look at the window. Won't look out the window, we'll look at the window.
The Ironwood Grove.
Oh my god, this is fine window craftsmanship. Good god, this glass must have been so damn expensive. In my house, we just use rags. The fact that that is glass actually probably did mean those were quite expensive at the time, because, didn't George R.R. Martin say that Westeros is kind of supposed to be kind of an alternate reality version of Earth? So it would be in like the 12th century, kinda. So yeah, this kind of time period with those kind of windows wouldn't go well. It'd be expensive. Let's look at the medical supplies. Have a good old stare. I am gonna touch the bucket.
Rather cute little creatures, aren't they?
No, they are horrible. Yes. Okay. This just kind of continues in my theory that, that maesters are really odd in a Game of Thrones or in Song of Ice and Fire. Like, almost every single maester is kind of a neurotic mess, as far as I can tell. Yeah, don't mind me, I'm just gonna grab, like, all of your medicine in case I get injured again. Not that I know how to use any of this, it, of course. This looks like celery. Like, really, like, wild celery. Celery growing all up out in the world. Talk to the maester when you finish exploring. Okay, good. Maester, I'm in. Show sword! Yeah, go on. Have a look at my sword, maester.
It's a good thing you've done, bringing that back to House Forrester. By right, that belongs to Lord Ethan now.
Is that... I'm wondering, is that Valyrian steel? I don't know. Let's have a look at the maester.
Keep moving. I need to see you walk.
What's his name? Oh my god! Ortengren? Maester Ortengren.
No, you see there? You're limping again.
I'm fine, really.
Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Why do the White Hills hate the Foresters?
That is a good question.
I think it's safe to say the feeling is mutual. There's been enmity between the two houses for as long as anyone can remember. I don't doubt someone killed someone, which led to more killings of someones, and then, well, here we are.
Sounds like the, Oh, bugger! There's two Riverlord houses. I think one of them's Crakehall? I don't know, but I do know there are two Riverlords houses that are like that, where, like, 3,000 fucking years ago, one of them I think it was, like, one of them killed another one's wife, and then these two Riverlords houses have been being pricks to each other constantly, despite the fact that in the endless attempts at, making peace, they've intermarried so many times that they're basically the same house in terms of their genetics, but they still hate each other based on the flag. It's dumb.
Who is the new lord of House Forrester?
Why, Ethan, of course.
Yes, I am. Sorry.
At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned. Advising the late Lord Forrester was an honor.
I'm getting the feeling
advising Ethan, his third-born son, is challenging. There's still so much he has to learn. Yet the very fate and future of this house rests in his hands.
Why is it that I'm getting the feeling that this Ethan Forrester is a prick?
When you think about it.
Yeah, okay, he's a prick. I've got it. Okay.
The White Hills want Forrester Ironwood.
They'd take it all if we'd let them. Especially now with the Boltons in power. And proceed to clear-cut every last inch of it until there's nothing left. Just as they've done before.
Yes, what will become of me, given that I'm a squire?
What will happen to me now?
Excellent question. Under normal circumstances, you could join Sir Roiland and his men. Although, given the circumstances of your... circumstances, it becomes a bit tricky, doesn't it? I suppose it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Oh, bugger.
Lord Forrester promoted me. At the Twins, I'm no longer a squire, if that matters.
It might, I suppose. But I'll defer to Lord Ethan on this.
Sorry, it's just weird hearing people saying Lord Ethan all the time.
Can I see Ethan? Is he here?
I'm just on the other side of the screen!
I'm afraid he's indisposed at the moment. He prefers not to be disturbed while practicing his lute.
is he that kind of prick? Is he like is he the musician kind of prick? Is that what's going on here?
Can I go now?
Don't be petulant.
Your leg will be fine. Any time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Lady Forrester, you look weirdly like Sansa.
We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family... I'm so sorry.
Mato. Off to bed now.
She doesn't look like Sansa. She just had kind of a... It's just the fire in her hair making it look lighter, and she's got kind of the Sansa from season 2 haircut.
Was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He was a hero, my lady. The bravest man on the battlefield by far.
Yet he was unable to save his own son.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion, but if you can remember anything, I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He fought valiantly, my lady.
Of course he did. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
No, wait, gave my vow.
Last words before he passed, if you can remember.
He said he loved you.
I gave a vow.
That's very kind of you to say.
Can't.
You have the Forester's sword.
Can't say the last words.
This
can't do it.
This belongs with Ethan now. He's the new lord of the house.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response. It's too dangerous, especially now. Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
Of course there's a guy with a burnt face and black armor.
Roiland. I do, but now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with
oh,
Ramsay
bugger.
Snow, the
oh dear, one of the Boltons.
You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much, I promise. But now is not the time for vengeance.
If not now, when?
We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
Just fucking walks in.
Nothing.
Screams he's gonna cut off his dick.
While they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Gonna be reasonable.
Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him.
Actually, no. Eddard Stark was not smart, and that's how he died. He was really bullheaded and overly, decent.
It will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this... I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
Fuck the Boltons. One of their men killed my family.
Aye. You'll say it was justice. They'll say it was murder. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take. Which is why you cannot stay.
You fucking...
I cannot stay.
You can't send me away.
We have no choice, Garrett. Garrett.
Where would you have the boy go?
The one place that's safe, beyond the reach of the Boltons.
You're sending him to the wall. The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution.
Uncle, you can't send me to the wall. I'm not a criminal.
There'd be nothing we could do to protect you. To stay would bring destruction upon us all. I know that's not what you want. I know it's difficult to understand. But you must think of the house.
I'll do what's asked of me.
I know it doesn't seem fair, but it is what's best.
Am I ever gonna get a chance to mention this Northgrove shit to this guy?
That settles it.
Sorry, that fire is fucking with the frame rate, so anytime the fire's in the background, it fucks with the,
We haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you.
Wait, seriously, I'm not... Oh, come on, I must be given a chance to say this thing to this guy. I was told by a dying man to mention the Northgrove stuff.
I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given the chance. I would. And God's willing, someday, I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first. I know you're not a criminal, but Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great-uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
Well, it does seem that only people in the North really care about the North. Oh, no, only really care about the Night's Watch.
I know I'll see you again.
Well, yeah, there's 6 episodes of this game left.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
Oh, now I get to tell the fucker!
What?
Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message. He said, the North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
Shit's getting very conspiratorial right now.
For good reason. Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way.
What is this?
You kept your word. You haven't told anyone else, have you?
No, actually, not a soul.
This is important, Garrett.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
Well, shame I'm gonna be 300 fucking miles away on the fucking wall!
Will be vital to the future of this house.
Don't know how much help I can provide you from the fucking wall!
Become a ranger if you can. It will help.
Get rid to the stewards, you're gonna be mucking out stables. Zap, just taking the time.
Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Good God, you can tell that was made up.
Remember,
for the show.
You represent House Forrester.
Or rather, was made up for this game to sound like the show.
The honor and dignity of the house.
I'll serve with honor.
Try not to rape any wildling women, mate. I know it's a bit much to ask, given the fact that seemingly everyone else on the wall, except for people friends with Jon Snow, are willing to fuck just about anything that moves. But don't rape a wildling. Trust me, you don't want to do that.
Garrett, wait!
I'm slow-mo running. I will take this necklace. Thank you, my lady.
Be safe.
Oh yeah, don't say anything to the poor girl. Just fucking ride away on your fucking horse. Don't look back, don't say a word, just sulk. Sulk your brains out, mate. Sulk to the end of day. Sorry. Oh, so are we not playing as him anymore? Or have we...
Ethan!
Oh, so now we're playing as this guy. Okay. Yep, looks like a prick. He does, in fact, look like a prick. So I'm going to play this guy as a prick. Going to jump out at them with a sword.
He hides too well. And if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
Not saying a word.
Ryan, look who we've found.
Okay, no, that's weird. Lord Ethan and his brother Ryan. Because my brother's called Ryan.
It's just a game, Ryan.
Although, admittedly,
I don't like it.
My brother Ryan is 7 years older than me, so...
I thought we'd never find you again.
Well, you're
an... right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
You're an incredibly paranoid little kid, aren't you?
Ishmira was here. And Asher. And Roderick.
Oh yeah, don't spare a thought for fucking...
But Mira's in King's Landing, and...
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
Oh yeah, it's not like people die every couple of days in King's Landing.
I don't want her to die either. Maester Ortengren said...
Ortengren? That is an insane name.
I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
No, he's not.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
With my hair.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all, you are the lord of the house now.
He doesn't know me.
God damn it.
Or what I'm capable of.
I meant to say I'll have him punished.
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Yeah, because apparently everyone in Westeros fucking hates milk.
Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like, like a man.
As opposed to the pixie that you clearly are.
And Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
Wow.
A lord should know how to fight.
Wow. In a world dominated by men, your sister knows how to fight better than you. Oh, fuck.
Play here. You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, well, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious. The lord in training. And he never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are.
Level 12 dickhead who looks like a pixie and's got stupid hair.
The lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I promise, I won't change.
Yep, I'll be a cunt through and through, constantly.
Rather than a lord.
You'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Not really. It's not really how it works.
All I have to do is you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
Or I could just decide you don't get any sweets.
It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the lord.
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
Okay, so we got a forest-based PA system. Got it, cool. Okay, yeah, I know he was shouting, but still. Looks like they're in the middle of fucking nowhere, so the idea that he's just...
What's the matter?
Oh, he's right there!
Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected.
Oh, that prick.
He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well then.
He says while he walks in the other direction. Where are you going, mate? Are you going to grab something? Sorry, I need a twig to stick up Lord Whitehall's bunghole. Okay. Sorry, sir. The Great John. Behind there. Stick up bunghole. Great threat, that, really. The bunghole threat. You can tell Whitehill soldiers, because they have stupid
they
hats.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
The business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is. Was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong. So don't give him any satisfaction.
I'm not gonna.
You were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash.
I can handle Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
Get dogs. I like how they're having this loud, like, consultation in a room full of Whitehill soldiers. My god, can everyone afford bevers in this place? Wow, that man is astoundingly not
Lord
threatening.
Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life.
How dare you?
I dare, and I'll do as I damn well please.
Not when standing in someone else's fucking hall, you
and
won't.
No bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Calm yourself, old man.
You little fuck! That's how you talk to a lord.
When a lord comes into my hall and gives me shit.
On us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the north now.
I think the Boltons
are. Bolton is the warden of the north.
Aye, and we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries. You cunt.
Okay, all
Lord Ethan.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished.
Okay, literally, they throw out all subtlety in writing with these guys.
Things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Ah, Smug Prick. I was wondering when you were going to show up again. Didn't think it would be this quick.
Your man, the Squire. We were minding our own business. Keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
Garrod was only defending himself.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that.
Think of anything, that just speaks to...
How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldiers worth 100 of their type.
Given that one pig farmer killed two of your soldiers.
I know he's here. What have you done with him?
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me. Who's the one who did it?
I did.
What? That was my justice to deliver, boy. And you denied me of it. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Just fucking Lady Forrester appears out of nowhere.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
What the fuck does she have over him to make him act like that?
I mean, no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this is not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
I've heard enough, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
Still mine, here.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
You know what? I like this guy. Also, sorry, mate. You're not threatening. You're a blonde guy with a fucking bob cut. That's not scary,
mate. What's
wrong
about your son, my lady? He stood up to him like a true lord.
Only because I'm playing as him.
My son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee.
I'll kick him in the teeth! Okay, that... Probably not the best plan.
Word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
Yeah, kicking Roose Bolton... No, Ramsay Bolton in the teeth. Probably not the best plan right now. Okay, right, well... I don't know how long I've been recording, but fuck it. That seems like a good place to stop it, because I've got hot water going for a bath, and that's just a good place to stop it. So, that's going to have to be off me for now. I've been your humble writer, Cyrus Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone. I don't know if I enjoyed it. I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get. I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel. I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now.